This is your life, Peggy.
Yeah, Peggy! Yeah, Peggy! Yeah, Peggy, give her a table.
Here's her table.
Perfect.
Give her a table.
Say hello to everyone.
Well, first of all, before you settle down and have a few jars, you know, your own mates.
Quiet!
We'd like to show our appreciation for all the ups and downs you've given us and wouldn't give us a read of the paper. But we have some people here to say a few words tonight, Peggy. If you'd just bear with us for a while. I'd like to call Captain Pope up to say a few words.
I think I'm getting something out of this now. Yes, I'm getting it. I've been asked to welcome Peggy to this very surprise reception. I hope you're not too shocked, Peggy. I've known you for well over 20 years now, and I must say you've been a lovely shipmate to have. And as I say, on behalf of the officers, masters, and the crew of the Leinster, I welcome you to this surprise party. I have a telegram here I'd like to read from the crew at the moment who can't be here because they're earning a few bob. In actual fact, I'll just read it. It's actually for you. You should be. I shouldn't really have. I shouldn't really have given you the telegram. But the telegram goes: best wishes for a happy retirement. And may you always have fair winds and calm seas. Wow. And that's from the officers and crew of the MV Leinster.
Well, Peggy, I've been given the honour to present you this present tonight. On behalf of the crew, I want to wish you a very happy retirement. And as Captain Pope says... Whoa!
Here.
Peggy, on behalf of the company, it falls to me, and it's a great pleasure, I have to say this, because I know you for a few years. I know you've been in the company long enough to see a lot of changes take place, from the old ships, where we had to carry cattle as well. Some of these young ones around here wouldn't remember that, Peggy, but you and I do. I was there then too. I was there then. So you've seen many changes over the years, and hopefully a lot of changes for the better. And today, or yesterday rather, I had a look in the office to see if I could find anything bad about Peggy, or a warning or something that I might be able to find. But no, I couldn't find any. Sorry to disappoint you all, but only good things, nothing.
She's unique.
She's always attended on time, never sick. And I said to Mary, and you all know Mary's good at the records, and Mary said, no, Peggy's never sick, and she's always in. So, Peggy, I have to...
sick leave.
She got paid for that. Anyway, on behalf of the company, I'd like to present you with a small token. You're not supposed to say that. You're not supposed to say that, Joe. Anyway, Peggy, don't mind that crowd. You've been a very good employee for the company, and as a small token, I'm offering you this little present. It's one of the nautical things that you hang on your wall, and there's a little letter in it there as well for you. So, well done.
Frank Gilligan Jr. is still a bit under the weather over there. From all the members of the team in the world, and two particular members of the Gilligan family have shared a cabin with you. I'm one of the members of the Gilligan family who didn't share the cabin with you. It's been great knowing you.
Thank you very much, Frank. And now, can we have a representative of...
Mr. Brendan O'Brien.
Our export, sir.
Mr. Brendan O'Brien.
Brendan O'Brien.
Peggy, on behalf of both crew and the, we want to wish you every happiness in your retirement. It's been great working with you. You're a wonderful lady.
I know, I think Peggy would appreciate it very much if we'd all lived a long time.
Yeah! Come on, clap. All girls love.
New York,
what do I do?
I Thank you.